If you're a farm kid or prairie boy like us, you probably like driving diesel trucks, but we also believe in green energy solutions. We just got this battery-powered generator sent to us. So it's not really a generator, it's just a big battery. And they told us we can put her to the test, give our honest opinion on this bad boy, and let you guys see how she actually works. Stick around to the end of this video. We are going to show you our $450,000 energy management unit and answer some of your guys' questions like, why are there 9 inverters and only 10 solar panels? Or where the hell are the batteries? Or how the hell did this thing cost $450,000? In unboxing this thing, it looks like everything's really good quality, but so far really all I know about this is it's got the number 2000 in the title. There's some max 600 watt inputs to charge this thing with solar panels, and then a whole bunch of plugs where we can plug in our angle grinder. So tomorrow we are going to test this thing. Stay tuned, it's gonna be fun. So it's got the DC wireless charging pad there. I had my phone on it with the Otterbox and it doesn't seem to charge, but if I take it off, then it does, which kind of not good for construction sites because we want to protect our phones. But we unplugged our plumber here for the day and we're gonna plug him in and make him operate off the grid and see how he likes it all day long. He's just got a bit of a smaller angle grinder there. He says he's got a whole bunch of tools. He's framing for us and everything here. So. Let him plug it in and see if he can overload or surge this bad boy. We started out trying to cut heavy wall HSS with the Pecron and it overloaded it. So we switched to cutting out the entire sidewall of a 40-foot high cube container and it worked quite well through the lighter walled corrugation. So that I think only drew about 20%, not even, of the power from the Pecron. For staff, a lot of times they really like to go to the cordless angle grinder, and what sucks is these are really expensive. These are about 3 times more expensive than a corded angle grinder, and the corded angle grinders seem to run a lot longer. They don't quite get as hot as these things, so you can cook these way faster. So whenever I see people out in our yard and they're utilizing a battery-powered angle grinder, I get mad. I want them to plug in. But the issue is when you have a 5-acre shipping container yard, you don't always have power near a container, which is a great reason for these Pecron units. Okay, so now that we have plugged in tools and we've drawn this thing down to 53% charge, it's not really that green if we just plug it into a wall and charge this thing back up. So let's use the sun to charge it. It's Friday afternoon. I'm here with Dawson. He's our new engineer. A lot of people comment in our videos down below, engineers will do the dumbest things, but I'm actually an accountant by trade. Dawson is an engineer. So if you got any negative comments, you just tag his name in there instead of me. Stay off my back. We've MacGyvered this thing. We've got it plugged in. The port's on there. What is it?
248 volt panels feeding into the 2 separate ports, which are going to be able to charge at approximately 300 watts. If everything is going good, the sun is out, we'll see this thing charged up in maybe 1.5 to 2 hours.
That's crazy. Actually, it'll that fast. So right now it's reading 0 watts because it is super cloudy out right now. Probably the worst day to do this. So we're gonna leave it over the weekend and hopefully come back to 100% filled battery pack there. I think she's waterproof. Looks like it's got waterproof covers on it, eh? Should be good.
We'll find out.
We have a mobile welding rig and we almost feel like this thing is a good pair to that. Like if this was plugged in to the gas engine, when you're welding, you're charging. And then when you go to switch to the grinder, rather than leave your gas or diesel generator running just to run a 1500 watt angle grinder, this thing seemed to handle that quite well. So a lot of you oil filled welders out there that are working on pipelines and stuff, this is probably a tool that you guys all should have in your arsenal. My best friend's a welder. I'm definitely sending him a text and letting him know that, yeah, just even if you get free fuel, free oil changes, I know that that's one thing, but you're putting hours on your machine, and rather than that, and I guess you're polluting the air. As much as we're making gas pipelines, we still believe in solar and wind around here in Saskatchewan and Alberta. So yeah, check her out on Monday. So we're back here with Dawson and the Pecron, and we want to show you guys the differences between this very inexpensive unit and this very expensive unit. So Dawson, how do they compare?
Well, they're similar in some ways, but the Pecron's kind of made to service one person, where this is made to service over 150 people. This is a hybrid three-phase battery and generator energy management system. It takes in power from generators, takes in power from solar panels, and adds them all up to output power in a continuous fashion to the customer, to the cam, or to the service that is requiring continuous power. In the case of this unit, our battery packs are smaller because batteries are expensive, and we wanted more like just enough battery to last until generators can spool up and down, or if there's an upset and both the generators go down and we still have a little bit of time to figure things out and get things working again before the power goes completely out.
Another thing that we have available to these large scale shipping container solutions is BESS system. So supplier and great friend in the industry, Multiboxx, they're really working on that with a battery supplier out of Hong Kong and then the UK. So they got a really cool solution there that would tie right into this building. So this could be like the brains of the operation, and then that would give you I think it's a 1 megawatt, a 0.5 megawatt, or a 0.2 megawatt solution that they have there. And those are really exciting. It's all kind of new technology. A lot of it's built for South Africa and places where the temperature is a lot different than up here in Canada. So there might be some things that we know that we've learned through the building envelope and developing all these cool mods for our Arctic environment that we could assist with the design of that battery unit and make sure that those batteries don't freeze, because man, are they expensive. But there's some really cool solutions coming out. You know, there's mega packs or whatever that are $2 million each, but if we can find some $400,000 or $500,000 alternatives to that and really kind of help the planet not have 2-year lead times, that would definitely be the way to go here. So all of that's great for mining camps, for job sites, for potentially even military camps, or we have applications just for microgrids, like especially where we are here in Saskatchewan. We've got a lot of northern communities that are reliant on one single copper line feeding that entire community. And so a lot of these could be either just entirely replace that grid, or potentially just even in disaster relief. These things could just, I think, what did you say? Like we could deploy in 6 hours?
So this unit itself can be deployed into the field with its solar panels up in a matter of hours, but depending on what you're attaching it to, that's kind of where it comes into the issue. So it's ambivalent on the power source. Like you can feed this with a big battery, you can feed it with generators, you can feed it with a large solar panel array, and it manages the power and makes sure that it has continuous output to whatever you want to supply power to.
So what is this unit right here intended on powering?
This unit is intended on powering like a mobile camp. So it will power all of the water and wastewater and needs of a camp and provide them with the power. And it's designed so that it can't fail to provide power. It's basically, if something goes wrong in any one of the systems, there's 3 redundant systems that will feed back power to the camp, so you never lose power.
How did the costs run totally out of control on this? Like, is this equipment that expensive?
Yeah, like the equipment is all really expensive, especially when you get into like the industrial power and control system side of it. We're looking at a simple panel costing $10,000 to $15,000, with every breaker in the panel costing $1,500. And this system in particular is running three phase, so that adds up to even higher costs. So every single phase has its own set of inverters. And then to hit the power level that we need, 150 kilowatts, we have to run these inverters in parallel with each other. Three sets of three inverters to run a three phase power system. And they tie into a generator that also couples its power into the system. And it can also tie in a 48 volt solar panel array to provide solar power during the day and offset generator costs.
How many panels could you plug into this? I know we only have 10 installed on it, and we got a lot of flack on that. That's a lot of guts for only 5,400 watts of power.
So I believe this system is capable of installing well over 150 kilowatts of solar panels. So the array can be set up prior to installing the can, and you just plug it in. So power will come in through a port behind me here and plug into this big bus bar, and that will send solar power to each one of these inverters, which will either charge up the battery or send it directly to the source where it's required.
But if this thing costs $450,000, there's a lot of engineering inside of there potentially, but I mean the gear is expensive, and I guess even if the time is all said and done, that is the retail value of this unit. If it's supplying, like you say, 150 people, that's $3,000 per person for power to allow them to live, and you know, similar cost, maybe a little bit more per unit, but a very rugged and industrial solution.
Yeah, this is like a reliable grid tie power system that is going to have a very high reliability factor, probably just as good as the standard grid, if not better, because it's more localized. If you were to divide this into a community, it's not an extreme cost to install. It's a fairly reasonable cost. We really put a lot of effort into like making sure this is what we needed and it operated in the way we needed it to operate. And that took engineering hours, that took the help from some other engineers in the field, and years of effort to get to the point where we were happy with the product that we have.
Whoa, so all in all, this thing's pretty sweet. I'm sorry if some of the video wasn't too enthusiastic. We've been battling four rounds of COVID around here, but this thing is deadly. I mean, I want it as a part of my arsenal. I thought, hey, we got it for free. I told all my team that we're gonna run it over at the top lift and see if it survives that, and we knew it wouldn't. But everyone's, no. There's no way they're allowing me to run this over and demolish this unit, because we love it. It's going to be a part of our toolbox, and we recommend it. And so imagine there's gonna be links down at the bottom of our video. You can find this thing and purchase it. I don't know if we get commission on that or not. I don't think we do. So we truly just got this thing for free. There's nothing really in it for us to sponsor this video, but we did wanna check it out. And I don't know if I would have bought it otherwise, but now that I have one, I'll probably end up buying more of them in the future. And we can actually, maybe future mods, maybe we can integrate this into them, or a version of?
Yeah, we have some ideas for integrating these into storm shelters or something like that.
Yeah, just like a 2-hour backup power, just say a tornado rolls in, you lose power to the grid, at least you can run your fans or whatnot. So future videos, check that out. We got a lot of really cool stuff coming in 2024. So if you want to follow that along, please help us out. Subscribe to the channel, and also help us out. Give this video a like, ring the bell for notification, and we'll see you next time. Hope you learned something.